Happening here, one of the biggest music traditions in New England returns to the stage this Labor Day weekend. And of course, we're talking about the 16th annual Rhythm and Roots Festival. And here to talk about it today is Mary Burdette. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having us. It's really an exciting time.
Because it's an exciting festival. And yes. We were talking earlier and I was saying how I've never been, but my old boss, Joy, she's been a couple of times and says how much fun it is. She and her husband and daughter, they get up and dance all the time. And that was a big part of it that you said. It's a big dance festival.
It's a big dance festival. And it's this year we have an extra stage. We put another stage in, which is a workshop stage. And people can come and listen to great musicians, tons of music all weekend long. The gates open at 3 on Friday, and then the music starts at 4. We have wonderful food vendors, food and wine and things like that.
There's a smattering of everything. And
yes.
So, but I think at the heart of it too is the music. And you were saying a little bit about the workshops, because it's true, we all don't know what rhythm and roots music is.
Right.
Maybe you could break it down for us. So if we don't know what is it, Creole music?
Well, it comes from, you know, think of all the music from Louisiana and Texas. We kind of think of this year as a road show in or a road trip in reverse.
Okay.
Because if people wanted to take in all of these musicians that are coming, dozens of musicians, it would take people 3 months to do a
to
road
travel
trip.
All
yes.
around.
And so
yeah.
all people have to do is get to Charlestown, to Ninegret Park, and all of these great musicians are descending on
that area.
Ninegret
yeah.
at that time. And they're coming from Austin, San Antonio, New Orleans.
You just named three cities that I personally love.
Absolutely.
Yeah? Hawaii, right?
Hawaii, yes. Taj Mahal, who we've been wanting to have at the festival since year one, is coming all the way from Hawaii. So we have all these wonderful musicians coming to Rhode Island. Rhode Islanders come out and, you know, come and enjoy. And the workshops are really cool because you can learn about how the different types of music came to be, how Cajun music came to be, what are the, you know, what's traditional and what's not traditional, and you know,
what are the instruments too, right?
Yeah, there's a lot of fiddle and accordion. It's so happy.
And it's very eclectic too. There's a whole mix.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's not just music and it's not just getting up and dancing, but we know that that's a lot of it. And that's
right.
That's a lot of fun. But there's also gourmet food.
Absolutely. We have a lot of regional and ethnic foods. A lot of seafood, a lot of beer and wine, you know, that sort of thing.
Which is always fun when you're dancing, too.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's also, we have a wonderful family stage that is really packed with really wonderful artists from Rhode Island.
Mm-hmm.
Keith Munslow is going to be one of the people there, and he's a hoot.
So we've got people from all over the country, and we've got people locally. We have food, we have music, we have everything. It sounds like it's going to be an incredible event that people should definitely check out.
Totally.
And it's not like summer's ending. We can check this out.
Yes,
so thank you so much, Mary,
for
coming here and telling us about it. And if you want more information, you can head to our website, WPRI.com, and click on the Roadshow.